Hello everyone, and welcome to my video guide of where to find the secrets of Pandaria. In this short video, I'll show you where you can find the so-called secrets, which basically is nothing more than either grey items that vendor for a bunch of gold, or just gold directly. I'll also be adding coordinates to each location in the video description below. We'll start off in the Jade Forest. Our first stop is for a little teapot, sitting upon a table at the northwest side of the map. Next, we have the Pandaren Ritual Stone, also at the northwest side of the map. Staying at the northwest side of the map, we now have the Lucky Pandaren Coin. Up next, we have an abandoned chest, lying on the shore near an unfinished boat. Now it's time for a little grave robin at the southern part of the map. I should note that stealing the offering of Rememberance gives you a shameful debuff, but nothing that disrupts your gameplay. At the very edge of the southern part of the map, we can also find a sunken ship with a chest inside. That's it for Jade Forest, so onwards to Kun-Lai Summit. First up, we have the statue of Xuen, lying at the bottom of a big pool of water. Next up is a Mogu tablet, leaning against a big statue. At the back of this cave, you can find the treasure of the sprites, which in the end is but a simple chest. The shrine of Rikktik holds a small but lootable chest. Yet again, at the back of a cave, we find a treasure chest, this time guarded by a single quest mob named Chocho the Wicked. Now this one is a bit tricky, the terracotta head of a Mogu statue. It has a random spawning location within the ruins. Cliffs of this mountain pass, a group of Grummel adventurers appear to have been ambushed, leaving behind a small lootable chest. As we leave Kun-Lai Summit, we enter Townlong Steppes, and right on the northern borders of these lands, a small crate of goods can be found near a Mogu weapon master called the Blade. next treasure is hidden in a cave on the south side on the isle on which Nisau Temple is placed. This time though, it's not all the way in the back, but right beside Hogalon, the Lost Watcher. Near the roots of the tree of Kri'vess, which is basically in the middle of the map, a small piece of hardened amber can be found and looted. At the southern borders of Townlong Steppes, another piece of lootable amber can be found, this one with a moth encased inside. Leaving Townlong Steppes and moving into Krasarang Wilds, we found the Saurok stone tablet in a cave near the back. Onwards to the vermin burrows of the Valley of the Four Winds. One of them contains a small chest, often containing a necklace. And lastly, the Hammer of Folly in the Veiled Stair, right beside where we often meet up with Rathion. That's it for this guide, so thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed it, and until next time,
something to doing?